We all know it can be quite useful to share visual information, and I want to introduce you today to my favorite screen capture and annotation tool, which is Greenshot. Greenshot is a free program that's available for both Windows and Mac. You can get it from getgreenshot.org. Once you install Greenshot, you'll see that you have a number of different options when you click on the icon from the system tray. So we've got the ability to capture the region, capture the last region. So if you want to capture the same space that you've captured previously, capture the window or the full screen. There's even an option to capture Internet Explorer. Hopefully you're not using Internet Explorer, but it is still certainly there. And once you've actually sort of described the section of the screen that you want to capture, you have all these different options to save as, with a number of different formats and locations. Save directly with your preferred file output settings. You can open in the image editor, which is sort of my favorite thing to do, and I'll talk to you about that in a little bit. You can copy to the clipboard, send to the printer, and sort of have that information captured inside a number of different programs. So let's have a look at how we can use this tool. I'm just here in a screen for logging into Gmail, and I'm going to hit the print screen key on my keyboard. You'll see this gives me the ability to actually capture the region, so I can hold down the mouse and drag it across and bring it sort of as large or as small as I want to. And then at the bottom of the screen, you'll see that we have these options pop up. So if I wanted to, I could just save this directly. I could save it in a particular location. But I think what I'm going to do today, and this is kind of my favorite thing about this particular program, is that I do have the ability to open it in the image editor. And there's some great things that you can do in the image editor. And the first thing I probably want to draw your attention to is you can see that we've actually captured the mouse cursor. So you may want to leave that there. That may be a very important piece of information depending on what you're attempting to do. But you can also, and it depends a little bit on the type of cursor you have, but you can actually make it a little bit larger. But what I tend to do is I'll just actually right click on this one and go delete. So I don't need that particular piece of information there. But I want to talk to you a little bit about some of the options that we have over here. So first of all, if you do have any personal information, we want to make sure that we're not inadvertently sharing that as well. So we have the ability to obfuscate. That's a great word. So if I click on this one, and maybe I can just drag it over the portion of the email address that I want to hide. And in this case, it's obviously a made up example. You'll see that it'll actually blur out that information. I can sort of tweak how that looks. Another thing, and you can imagine that if you're providing this information to some computer newbies, we want to make sure that what they're seeing in this screen capture is very similar to what they'll see on their computer. In this case, I actually have an extra browser extension for LastPass. So there's a little icon there that I can see that they probably won't. So let's actually get rid of that one. So I'm going to come up, and we've got a number of different shape tools here. I'm going to just grab the rectangle and I'm going to drag it over here. You can actually see that it's already the right color, but let's just explore some of these different options here. So we've got the line thickness, we've got the line color. So if I wanted to make that a different color, in this case, I probably don't want a line thickness at all. I don't want a line, so I'll just bring that back to zero. We have all these different options, so you can specify HTML color in the hex code format or RGBA. You can make it transparent, so if I drew it out and obviously it's there, which is great, but it's not obscuring the thing I want it to obscure, so I'll go back to the fill color. And I can actually just click on the color picker and drag that out and just grab a bit of that background color, which in this case is actually just pure white, and I can go apply. And there we can see that that's no longer in our image. So that's not going to confuse the people that we want to share this with. So there's a number of different things you can do. Often there may be cases where I want to really draw attention to something, and I might make it transparent and then just bring back in some sort of line thickness here so I can really draw attention to it. There are a number of different options, though. There's the ability to add a speech bubble. You can actually highlight things. So if there is something that you really want to draw attention to, we can drag that over. And there are a number of different options for that one as well, which is really cool and worth exploring. But imagine if we were explaining a process to a new student. One of the great things that we do have here is actually the counter. So I can click here. And, you know, maybe I need to explain to the person reading this that they need to fill in their email or phone first. And then we want them to click on the next button. And obviously I've got the ability to add borders and change colors to those. So if there are other colors that those things need to be in, you can certainly do that. And you can also change the number. So if maybe you've got a number of different steps over different images, we could just sort of arbitrarily change the number on this one and make it number three or four. So wherever you happen to be counting from, that's wonderful. So these are just a few things that you can do with Greenshot. It's a really wonderful program that I really enjoy using, and it is free for Windows users. I believe there's a small fee for Mac users as well, but I highly recommend this to Windows users. I really enjoy it. Obviously, the thing to keep in mind is, depending on, you know, what you're using this for and where you're sharing it, it's important to consider the accessibility. So you may need to offer some alternative text. You may need to have a description of your image. Those are certainly important things to explore as well. And you can go, and if you want to find out more about Greenshot, you can head over to my LinkedIn articles, Screen Capture and an Annotation with Greenshot, which you can see behind me there. So thank you very much. Do you have a favorite screen capture tool? I'd love to hear about it in the comments. Let me know. Thanks.